Guys, in this video, I will show you how to use our TD indicators for trading Forex market or CFD market. So TD indicator is an indicator that uses the bourse data, pure price action data, for showing you how the market trends or where is the current direction of the market. The indicator uses the X previous bars or and by default four previous bars and then data and compare the correct the current bar or the close price with the high or low of the four previous bar and add a number to the bar. The numbers are sequential, so it goes from 1 to 9 by default, but in our indicator you can change the default number or increase it to any number you want to. Let's add the TD sequential indicator to our chart. My chart is Australian dollar versus United States dollar, as you can see. Okay, TD sequential. As you can see, the period is by default 4. It's how people use this indicator, but if you want to, you can change this number to any other number you want to. And it's a little bit complicated indicator because it shows numbers on each bar, and alongside the number it has another series of numbers called countdown number, which goes from 1 to 13 and there is a perfect buy or perfect sell signals. By default in our indicator the countdown number is not shown and it's disabled, but you if you want to, you can enable it and set this to yes. And here is our sequential indicator. As you can see, the maximum bars number is 9. You can increase it to any number you want to. And here you can set the side of numbers, so the up numbers should come on top of the bar or on the bottom of the bar. For regarding the parameters, you can check the indicator documentation there. You can find the detailed description for each of these parameters. So here we have bullish price, bearish price flip, perfect buy signal, perfect sell signal, and this profitable and losing signal set in based on statistics. Let's go to add the indicator on our chart. It will get a little bit time to show up. Okay, as you can see, each bar has a number. Let me zoom out, zoom in. Okay, so here are all the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The red number shows the down bars or bars that goes down, and the green number shows the up bars. It goes from 1 to 9 and it restored again from 1. On the first bar, there is a signal. If some other conditions meet, the indicator will show this. This dots that is a perfect buy signal or a perfect sell signal. You can use this indicator for different purposes, like finding the direction of trend, trading reversal signals by using this perfect buy and sell signals, and lots of other things can be this indicator can be used for. But what we did is we developed it to other indicators that uses the TD sequential trading system. It is a whole trading system in the back end and shows you only the buy and sell signals. These two indicators called the TD breakout and TD trend rider. The TD breakout and TD trend rider is two multi time frame indicators. By multi time frame, I mean those two indicators uses multiple time frames data and uses those multiple time frames data to show you trading signals. Let me remove the TD sequential indicator from my chart and add one of those two. Let's start with the TD breakout. Okay, it's the TD breakout signal. You can find the link of this indicator on the video description. And the only parameter that this indicator has is this periods number. For description regarding this parameter, please check the indicator documentation. As you can see, there is two other time frames, medium time frame and longer time frame. Medium time frame and longer time frame are time frames that you have to set based on your current trading time frame. Suppose if you are trading on daily time frame, for medium time frame you have to set it to weekly, and longer time frame set it to monthly. If you are trading on a hourly chart, you this medium time frame should be set to daily, and longer time frame should be set to the weekly time frame. Set it based on your current time frame. As you can see, my time frame is daily time frame, so I will set the medium time frame to weekly, and the longer time frame, which is by default weekly, I will change it to the monthly. And there is nothing else. I disable the statistics. Regarding the statistics, please check the indicator documentation. And okay, as you can see, the signals are showed up on my chart. I told you this indicator uses the two other time frames data alongside this time frame data for calculation and showing these signals. And the TD breakout signal, as the name suggests, is a breakout trading indicator. It shows a signal if the bar closes below X previous bars, low or high, and by using some other formula for getting the trend direction from longer time frames by using the TD numbers, and it uses a specific TD sequential number to find out if there are more room for price to go in direction of trend or not. So if the TD sequential number on your longer time frame is suppose 9, it will not show up the trading signal on that direction, because it considers that the trend is already very exhausted. But if it is 5 and the medium time frame is also something like 5 or 6, then it considers that there is room for price to move more on the trend direction, and then it checks the current time frame data. If the current time frame, the current bar, is closed below the X previous bars, which you set on the periods parameter, or above that number of bars, then you will see a trading signal. I recommend you to use this indicator on a longer time frame like daily, but you are free to use it on any other time frame. Let me move the chart on the left, so you will be able to see more signals of this indicator. And this indicator doesn't repent or anything like that. Once a bar, it doesn't show any signal until the bar is closed. So once the bar is closed, the signal will appear, and after that the signal will not disappear. If you load the chart again or remove and add the indicator again, you will see the same signal. As you can see, all signals are not profitable, and it's how real trading works. But when a signal is profitable, you can make for your losing signals. Okay, let me change the symbol to something like GBP USD. Okay. I zoomed out. I use these two indicators by myself, and I have used these two indicators on some of my algorithms, but I don't use it alone, like trading just these signals. I use it as a part of my whole trading system. So I recommend you to do the same. But if you want to trade this alone, you should have a good risk management strategy, so you will be able to recover back your losses from a single winning trade. Okay, I think it's enough for TD breakout. Let me show you the TD trend rider indicator. both of these indicators and the backend uses the TD sequential indicator. If you don't want to use these two indicators, you can still use the TD sequential indicator. But as I said before, the TD sequential indicator is a little bit complicated, and you have to interpret its data by yourself. The good thing about TD breakout and TD trend rider is that the indicators themselves interpret the data of multiple time frame and show you the result, so you don't have to spend any time checking multiple time frames, and you can focus only on your trading and risk management. Okay, it's TD trend rider. Let me set this to the weekly and this to the monthly. Okay. The difference between TD trend rider and TD breakout is this: it's a little bit kind of a pullback trading. So when a trend is pullbacks, it shows a signal, but you can find several times that the both indicators show same signals, but the in the code there is a huge difference. And let me tell you something else. In the back end of these two indicators, I haven't used anything else except TD sequential and some other price action trading techniques. No other indicator is used. So the system is very simple if you know how the TD sequential works. If you don't, you don't have to know. You can use this indicator without caring about TD sequential and it's use these signals for your trading. As I said before, you can use this indicator for any market, not just Forex. You can use it for indices. Let me switch to S&P 500 to show you. Wait a minute. Okay. Let's just 3500. Okay. Here is the 500. Okay. As you can see, the indicator works very well on this one too. Not sure why. I think there is not enough data or something. No, there is data. Something is wrong with my FX Pro CTR 500. I don't know why it doesn't show more signals in here. Maybe it's because of the lack of data on longer time frames. Let me set both to the weekly. I see more signals, but still no signal here. Okay. As you can see, that place it works very well. It can capture the trends from start to the end. Let me go to the gold. I have to change the indicator. Longer time frame back to the monthly. Okay. I think that's okay. 2010 is end of gold historical data on FX Pro. So you can see there are lots of good signals. Let me show you a shorter time frame of EUR/USD. Something like maybe H4 or H1 has a main time frame. I think H1 is good. And daily and weekly as medium and longer time frame. Weekly, okay. If you want to use only one another time frame data, you can set both medium and longer time frame to the same time frame. So if I set both to the daily, the indicator will only use the daily time frame data. And you can see there are lots of signals. Well, it changed really good. I don't trade hourly chart, I only trade daily chart, but if you want to trade hourly chart, you can use this for trading hourly chart. Lots of good signals here. As I said, it's all based on TD sequential, and I really like the TD sequential indicator. It's simple, easy to understand, and it's kind of a fully functional trading system. You don't need anything else when you use TD sequential. It's why I really liked it. Let me add this again to the hourly chart. Oh, I have to decrease, I think, the distance to something like 5 and 3 pips is okay. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's how price moves on any other market. It's not keep moving on the one direction. It moves, it's pull back, it moves again and it pull back, or it reverse fully. So it's how the whole mean reversion algo trading strategies work. Suppose after each move on the direction of the trend, price pulls back to the mean and then moves again. So if it moves a lot on the trend direction, there is huge chance that it pull back, so you don't have to enter. And that's what the TD trend rider and TD breakout indicators use for longer time frames. It checks the longer time frame, that is there any more room for price to move in direction of trend by using this TD sequential numbers. If it found out that there is more room, suppose the last bar was number 5 down bar, it will find that, okay, there is 2 or 3 next bars can price can go down again, so I can find a check for down a sell signal on the current time frame. If the price, the last bar number on medium or longer time frame is something like 8 or 9, it will consider this as the price is already exhausted and it's already moved a lot in direction of trend, so it's not a good time for going in and riding the trend. And it waits and it will see if there will be another opportunity or not. If you have any question or you like to know more, please check out the indicators links in the video description or leave a comment. There are some good tutorials on internet about TD sequential. You can search on Google the TD sequential and you will find a lot. Lots of people use this system. Lots of professional traders use this on different markets, in stock market, in any other market you can think of, people use this TD sequential system. Okay, this video ends here. Thanks for watching and being with me to this point. Bye.